If you're the type of person who is extremely scared of failure and ends up not doing anything in life because of it, please watch this video. This might be the reason why you're stuck. We are so scared of failure that every time we try to create plan A, we make sure there's always a plan B so that we avoid mistakes, we avoid failures. And oftentimes when you apply this on business, it seems like it's a hamster wheel going on and on and on. It feels like you're not moving forward. It feels like you're stuck, you're stagnant, and that's just about it. You feel like you are going to give up anytime soon. I know it's so many people that has business ideas. For example, this person would want to say, I want to start an e-commerce store today. The next week, you would hear him say, I'm going to make a course about making courses. So it's just this person that is trying to come up with so many business ideas, try each one. And if something doesn't work for a week or two, then that person would give up in that very business idea, proceed to the next one. And it goes on and on and on. Like what I said, a hamster wheel with no finish line. But the question really is, does changing niches really take your business to the next level, or it's just going to keep your business or your pace wherever you are right now at this very lifetime? It just keeps you where you are and it doesn't allow you to move forward in life. I say when you are feeling this way, you are currently stuck in a hamster wheel, and that is exactly why in this video, we are going to talk about why this is happening and how we can get out of this very situation. I'd like to quote Seth Godin, who said, "Winners quit all the time. They just quit the right stuff at the right time." And this video today is a reflection of me after reading The Dip by Seth Godin. It's a very short read, easy to understand. And I have noticed that a lot of my students in my program are actually going through a lot of dips, which causes them to get stuck in their very own business journey. So I decided to share that with you today with one very simple point. In trying to achieve something, we always experience the dip. The dip is this very framework or a step-by-step process or basically just a random diagram that explains what happens when we are trying to achieve our goals and aspirations. Take a look at this very diagram here. When you start a business idea, you get super excited about it, and hence you will put in a lot of effort to keep it going. After you get excited though, at some point you will lose patience, get stressed, and lose momentum. It starts to go downhill from there. This is when we think it's not worth it, or we question the worth of what we are doing, right? And then we arrive at the dip where we either give up and or proceeding to a different business idea. What we do not know, however, is that mastery and success goes only upward from there. But since we stopped, well, we never achieve it. When we change to a new business idea, the same process happens. We start and then we get excited and then we lose patience, get stressed, lose momentum, arrive at the dip again, and only to quit. This is why this area of achieving something is called the bad point of quitting. It's such a waste of time, effort, and energy to go all through those stages and just quit. It's like a video game where you continue playing only to restart it over again because the boss is too hard to fight. So what are we supposed to do? I quote Seth Godin again, "The brave thing to do is to tough it out and end up on the other side. The mature thing is not even to bother starting something because you're probably not going to make it through the dip. And the stupid thing to do is to start, give it your best shot, waste a lot of time and money, and quit right in the middle of the dip." So indeed, we are supposed to tough it out all throughout this very experience and process of trying to achieve something. And a lot of times, this very dip, that dip diagram that you have seen earlier, that very mark right there that says the dip, it's actually a long period of time. And a lot of people don't have the patience to keep on moving forward when they already experience the dip. And after the dip, there's this what we call an uphill battle towards mastery and success. And a lot of people also give up at that point when they are like extremely close to getting the gold at the end of the rainbow. And so this is one of the biggest lessons that I learned from Seth Godin and his book is that when you are trying to achieve something, you either start it and go all in on it or do not even start it at all. This is actually a very bad advice for the people who has very low self-esteem because, okay, I'm not just going to bother trying anything because I am not going to be good enough for it, right? So everyone who thinks that they have a self-esteem issue, when they hear this advice, it's like, okay, I'm not going to even start it or bother starting it because I'm not going to be good enough anyway. I'm not going to make it through the dip. Seth Godin says that it's a good idea. It's a mature thing to do. But for me, if you put your mind into something that you really want to happen, most likely you really are going to pass through the dip no matter what, right? When you just put your head on something, when you really think about it for a very long time, this is what I really want to achieve. I'm going to achieve it regardless of what obstacles is going to come in my way. That's the time when you can get through the dip. And this is that's the only part that I don't agree with Seth is like, why would you give advice to people to not even start anything because they cannot make it through the dip? It's a really good concept. It's a good framework. But the point here really is if you're going to start something, continue pushing through so that you can see what's the other side of the rainbow or what's on the other side of the mountain or whatever you want to call it, right? It's just super important for you to keep on going. And yes, this concept of the dip, again, let me recall to you that it's going to be a long period of time before you even go to that uphill battle because it will look like you are very stagnant on something. A concrete example is when I changed niches. So this is a lesson for the people here who always changes from one business idea to another. Well, this is my very own experience. Back in the day, I was a book cover designer. And at some point before I reached 100K a month, the thing was, I felt like I did not find any clients at that very certain time. It was like 2 months, 3 months, or 4 or 5 months that I did not have a client. And if I have known the dip back then, I would have identified that that was the current dip of my life. And because I did not know that, what I did is I changed from one business idea to another and I told myself that I'm just going to offer sales funnel design to a lot of people because it's going to be an in-demand skill, whatever kind of reason that I put in my head. And so that was the very skill that took me to 100K a month. But the question is, would I have hit 100K a month if I was doing book cover designs? Of course. It was just that at that very time of my life, I did not even realize that was a dip. And so I quit at the bad point of quitting. I did not reach mastery and success. And so I proceeded to something new. Good thing though, when I proceeded to something new and I reached the dip at that point in my life in a new business idea, which is sales funnel design, offering that very service to a lot of people, I also experienced the dip at one point in that very specific business. But I did not give up this time because I realized that if I'm going to give up on this one, what else am I supposed to do? I think I have tried 24, 25 different things before I even arrived to that very place in my life where I was so sure that I'm just going to do sales funnel design for a very long period of time. And so that's the lesson. We're going to conclude here with the idea that number one, you have to seek failure. So many of us are so scared of failing, but we have to seek failure in a sense that when you are walking down that path, failure is going to slap you in the face and be like, no, you're going the wrong way. This is the right track. And who doesn't want someone who's going to guide you to the right way? It's just that it's a little painful because it's going slap in a fam. Yeah. The failure is really going to slap you in the face. It's going to be painful, but at least you learned where the right direction is. And that would only mean that it's going to go uphill from there. Okay. Number two, if you are going to experience the dip, recognize that it's going to be a very long period of time, but that doesn't mean that you have to stop there. Don't quit at the bad point of quitting, because again, what Seth Godin says, winners quit all the time. They just quit at the right thing at the right time. So don't ever quit at the bad point of quitting. No. Alrighty. So there you have it. This is one of the topics in niching down or identifying your niche. And this is also something that I teach a lot in the module 2 of Create and Rise Academy. Create and Rise Academy is a program that has been helping freelancers to work less, charge more without the help of any type of middleman, agency, or freelancing sites. And I have helped over thousands of students already. And if you want to become that very highly paid freelancer or reach great heights in freelancing, just simply click the link in the description and the page will take you there. And so thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have learned something. I will see you in the next one.